Hey guys, this is Min, and this is my 20th video. In this video, I'll actually be playing a game of chess with another YouTuber, Holly the Mayor. She's a great YouTuber, and she uploads a lot of amazing content. She plays many games such as Town of Salem, Secret Hitler, Among Us, Undertale, Codename, Overcooked, and even recites some spoken word poetry that she writes herself. So I've included her link in the description, so you guys feel free to check her out. And here we begin. So, first I play e4, so what I've actually decided to play this game is to just sacrifice my queen on move 3. And what that does is, it's kind of this fun thing that we're doing, so I'm gonna try to win being down a queen the whole game. So I want to see if I can actually pull it off, and yeah, so it's just something we decided to do for fun. So as you guys can see, I made the earliest queen sacrifice possible, which is go to f3 and then sack my queen on move 3. So after that, I just do normal developing moves, I guess. Knight c3, knight f3, moves like that. So I actually decided to go to knight e2. Because, yeah, I can go to g3 and then push f4 and have ideas like that. So she does put her bishop on e7. I think I'll push a3. Okay, she castles. I can't really castle at the moment. I'm thinking of d3. Yeah, I'll play d3. Yep. a6, g3. So basically, fame kettling my bishop, since I did put a knight on e2. So my bishop can't develop on the f1 a6 diagonal. So I castle. Right now, I am still down a queen. So I'm just making, I guess, passive moves. Since I can't really afford to go on the offensive with being down a queen, I guess I'll just play passive, avoid trades, and hope she makes mistakes that I can exploit. This is actually very challenging for me, since she is a very good player, but we just decided to do this for fun, where I sacrifice a queen, see if she can still win. Yeah, so she pushes that pawn. I'm not sure, like, this is very challenging, I guess. I'll play knight d5. Attack the bishop. The bishop is dead, but I mean, it's a trade, but I guess I'd rather have the bishop off the board. And put bishop or pawn on f4, maybe push later, open up the diagonal. Okay, so she stops me from pushing the pawn. I could be going for the bishop trade, but might as well just develop knight, right? So she's actually playing very strong so far, hasn't made any mistakes I can do. So I'm gonna go to g4. Okay, she's gonna trade. I'll take back the knight, of course, since I don't want to break my pawn structure. Yeah, this is actually okay, considering I did sack a queen, but I mean, it's as okay as you can get when you sack the queen move 3. So yeah, like I said before, she did put her knight on g4 eventually. So I'm not really looking forward to trading that bishop, so I'll move it. Very simple. She makes a normal rook development. I'm evaluating this move where I take the pawn on f6, and if she takes it with g7, I can put a bishop on h6 eventually, right? So I instead decide to put my bishop on h3, attack the knight. If the knight moves, then I have the rook. Then I can take the rook, right? And the only other place to go is, yeah, like I've highlighted, h5, but then I just push f3. And the knight is forced to move. And when the knight moves, the rook will drop. So I did win back some material here, which I guess is better. Yeah, I just pre-move that. Yeah, I can also try to flag her. And by flagging, I mean just run her out of time, I guess. She's taking some time. Yeah, she moves a knight back to e5 and I take. She takes with queen. So, I mean, now I gained some material back, which is good, but it's still not enough. I'm still down a queen for a rook. It was a queen for a knight, but now I've managed to get it to a queen for a rook, which is more, I'd say more ideal, but there's still a long way to go if I actually want any realistic chances of winning. She retreats her knight. Push my pawn, reopen that diagonal for the bishop. Oh, she moves her king, which is an interesting move, actually. If her pawn on g7 wasn't there, then I can take f6 with a fork on the second rook. But unfortunately, she does have a pawn there, so... But, I mean, it's just an idea to keep in mind for the future, right? And yeah, of course, she pushes that pawn, but the bishop is still there. But once that bishop... I mean, the bishop doesn't really have many places to move, but... Eventually, if the bishop moves, then you can have something. Wait, hold on. I'm thinking of this. Moving the bishop there. If she takes... If she takes my pawn, then I go knight. A bishop takes pawn. And if she does bishop takes, then I knight take with fork. Or she can block with knight, which I'm leaning towards what she's going to do. She's going to block with knight on e6. Yeah, I anticipated that. Then I'll just take g6. If she takes back, then that discovers my rook on the f6 square. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. It's not bad. Yeah, I took g6. If she does take back with the pawn, then I'll just sack the rook for the pawn, I guess. Because I get two pawns this way, right? Yeah, I can sack my rook. And then bishop takes, knight takes with check, and fork the other rook. It's okay. Oh, she took with the knight. Okay, that's really good. Hold on. So now I can just take with the bishop, because she moved the blocker. And if she recaptures, then I fork the rook. She recaptured. Okay, so I held the rook down. Okay, now this is still losing, but at least it's manageable. It's two rooks against a queen and a knight, so I actually have, I'd say, fairly good chances, because it's two rooks and a pawn for a queen and a knight. So what Lycia says is I'm actually only down 1 point if we're looking at point value. But however, black is still better with the queen knight against double rook. But I mean, if I was able to capture the pawn on h5, then theoretically in point value, we'd be equal. Which, I know it doesn't sound too great since we're just purely looking at point value, but however, you have to keep in mind I did sack a queen in move 3. And it's very good that I've been able to get it to somewhat equal point value. But if I was able to win the knight, then I'm winning. Because two rooks against a queen, then I'm just winning. But I don't think it's very possible that I get the knight. I guess I can give check on g4. Doesn't do much, but worth a shot, right? Yeah, I can move my other rook to f1. She moves her knight back to block the check, I'm assuming. And then I'll bring out... Oh, she doesn't. I'm still gonna bring out my rook though, because then I can put rook gf4 and then try to take the pawn on f7 to fork the queen. If I get her queen down, then that's game. Okay, so she does move her knight back eventually. I can't do that anymore. I can't do the rook thing anymore because she'll just recapture with the knight and I'll be losing. So I guess I'll push, I'll make a pawn move. I'm thinking of a pawn move, so right now, maybe b4 or c4. So I did b4. Just open up this pawn. I want to see if I can get an open file, but it doesn't look like it. But at least I can move my rook to a6 at some point and try to win the, I mean a1, I can move my f rook to a1 at some point and try to win the a6 pawn, but I don't think it's much use. I'm still trying to go for the f7 pawn because it seems like a better idea. Okay, she moves her queen to h3, which leaves the pawn hanging. So the plan that I was planning to make actually worked out. So she's forced to go to h6, and now I'll go retreat to g3, counterattack the queen. Yeah, right now I think I'm doing fine. Like, I'm actually doing fine. I can't believe this. I sacked a queen move. Move 3? Yeah, and then right now I'm actually doing perfectly fine. It's a miracle. Yeah, I'm gonna go after the a6 pawn that I was talking about a minute ago. Yeah, I think I would actually consider myself to be winning now. I have a better position, a better pawn structure, as well as two rooks for point value-wise were equal. Oh, she's actually low on time. Actually, I don't even want her to flag. Like, right now, I think I'm gonna give her some time. I don't even want her to flag, because obviously, if I didn't give her time, I think she'll just win for sure, because, I mean, she has, like, 3 seconds left, but honestly, I want to play this game out. I want to see how it ends. Like, I just want to win without flagging her. I just want to see if I actually have the ability to. I must have a checkmate of sorts here, right? I can go to g3, win the knight. Yeah, I'm definitely better here. Yeah, I may be able to make a ladder mate with the rooks, possibly. If I bring my rook to f8 and then deliver mate on h8, assuming her queen doesn't do anything. But she's probably gonna give check on d1 or c1. To stop me from doing the ladder mate. Yeah, d1. I'll move my king up to g2, I guess. Yeah, she checks again. I'll block with the rook. Hold up, let me think. Yeah, I'll block with the rook. She's gonna take the pawn on d3, but I'm definitely winning here. I have two rooks against a bear queen, so this is so much better for me. I'll retreat the rook. Maybe to f6. Oh, she has no more time. I'm gonna give her some more time. Yeah, she did check me. I'll give her some more time. In a sec. Let me just figure out. Okay, now I'm gonna give her some time. Sorry, I'm just figuring out this position. Give me a sec. I don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, yeah. I win her queen here. Yeah, now I'm completely winning. I'm completely winning. So yeah, this is game. This is very much game. I don't even care. I'll give her the rook. I can promote because she has to take the rook and the pawn, and then her king's too far from this pawn. I'm actually gonna promote to a rook, since I sacked my queen and I was doing fine with a pair of rooks. I actually did it. I beat her with just a pair of rooks. I was able to outmaneuver her queen, knight. So I'm gonna promote to a rook. and made this game with a rock. So there you guys have it. This is the game. I hope you guys enjoy this video. She's gonna get mated very soon. So I guess this is the outro. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like my content, please subscribe, comment, like, and leave anything you want to say in the comments below. I will be going through the comments individually. And if you have any further game suggestions, put it in the comments as well. Also check out Holly's channel that I've linked. She does some really cool content for you guys to look at. So this is it. Thank you guys for watching. This is Mint. See you guys next time.